Welcome back to the channel, Dan Fox here, and today I wanted to just share a quick and dirty video about a solution to a problem that has driven me nuts for the longest time. And that is when you stick your YouTube links in your Instagram bio, anybody who interacts with that link just gets a in-app mobile browser, which causes a lot of problems. It'll just be easier for me to show you what I mean, so I'm gonna pull up my phone here. So I'm on Michael Shanebloom's page, by the way, fantastic photographer if you are looking for awesome photographers to follow. But notice how he shared a YouTube video link in his bio. Now the problem is, if I click that link, it loads the mobile version of the in-app browser. Now, you may say, but Dan, what's the big deal? Well, if I click on anything, if I try to interact with his video at all, I can't. I have to sign in. I can't like, I can't dislike. I wouldn't want to do that, but I can't subscribe. And this creates a bad experience for your audience because they can't interact with you. But it also creates a bad experience for you because no one can interact with your video. They can play the video and literally that's it. So all those likes, comments, subscribes you're asking for can't happen. Now, if you're an Android user, you can force it to open up in a different browser and load in the app. But I was looking for a solution that would work across all platforms. And the bottom line is I didn't want my viewers to have to take extra steps for something that should just work easily. Now, if we go to my page for a second, let me get back out of here. Let me go to my page. Now, notice I have a link here, and this is a YouTube video, but when I click on it, it loads directly in the app, and people can interact with it directly. Now, something I will mention right off the bat is there are services meant to address this specific problem. If you've searched online trying to figure out how to address this problem for yourself, you've probably come across the service URL Genius before, and I looked into that. And it seems to work really well, but ultimately the reason I didn't use that method is because it's 2 cents per click, and that's at the base level. You can pay more if you want extra features like automatic updating of links and stuff like that. But while 2 cents per click doesn't seem a lot at first, like that'll add up quick. And I wanted something that was a bit more predictable. So I'm using a service that I've already been using. A lot of YouTubers and bloggers use it. It's called Genius Link. And it's kind of a few things rolled into one. It's a URL shortener, which is really good for YouTube description sections when you need to save space. It's also great for any affiliate marketing because it can intelligently send people to the right place. But there's also kind of a buried feature that allows you to serve different devices different links, even though people have just clicked on one link. And that's what we're going to explore today. All right, so I'm hopping over to the computer here, and this is my Genius Link dashboard, and I've clicked on links. I have this grouped together by groups, something I'd recommend doing so you can keep everything tracked. So I have a little group here for socials. Oh, and something I forgot to mention is I pay $5 a month for Genius Link. So there's your price comparison. I think I forgot to mention that before. So what we're gonna do here is we're going to create a link, like one of these links I've created here, that will direct people depending on the kind of device that they're using. And this will allow you to bypass the Instagram in-app browser, essentially, using something called deep links. So first, what we need to do is we need to get the video ID for the video that you want to direct people to. So I've got my YouTube studio pulled up here, and you just go in, you grab your video, and it's going to be these numbers, or I guess letters right here. If you ever forget this, you can also find it if you are actually on a video. Let me pause this before it plays. If you're on the video, you're gonna see this kind of syntax up here. Watch ?V equals, and then it'll have your ID. And in fact, this is actually the URL you want. Not this short one, you want this long URL. So I'm gonna copy this, and I've already got a document pulled up here. And by the way, what I'll do here is I'm going to provide all of this information for you to copy, but I can't provide it in the YouTube comments because YouTube will automatically convert it to a hyperlink. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna paste this on a blog post to my website, and I'll put the link in the description, and you just go and copy it right off my website. But if you see here, I've got the syntax. So if I was, this video ID is the one I want. And what you would do is you replace every instance of video ID in these brackets with that code. So for the Android here, I'm gonna go find video ID, and you don't wanna change anything else except for video ID and the two brackets. So I'm gonna paste in there. paste in there, and you still want this full ID. I'm going to show you, or this full URL. I'm going to show you in a second. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back to Genius Link here. We're going to create a new link. We're just going to use the simple link. And this is this link. Actually, you can do a lot more with it than it seems right now. But at first, I'm just going to paste the URL in there. So here's where you can specify your unique URL. Now, if you don't make one, Genius Link will just assign you one. So I'll just put like awesome new vid. Oh, cool. It's available. So what you want to do then, you already have the URL pasted down here. You want to click this advanced checkbox. And this is what's going to allow you to route people. So you notice when I go down here, I have essentially like if then statements. If X happens, then do Y. In this case, what we want to build our if then statements on are the operating systems of the device they're using. Click on if here, go to OS. Whoops. Got OS Android. I'm just gonna add these all at once. OS iOS. And I'm also gonna want to do desktop. So I'll do Mac OS and Windows. Since you're building this unique link, you have to make sure you account for regular users too. So for the regular desktop, the Mac OS and Windows, just paste that full link in again. Now for the Android, we're gonna go back to our document here. And I'm going to copy this entire thing with the video ID in it that we made before. Paste that in there and do the same for iOS here. All right, hit save. All right, so we go back here. We're gonna grab our new link. Awesome new vid was the one we just created. So I'm gonna copy this. And I'm going to go over to my Instagram profile and edit this. It's just easier to do from a desktop, by the way. And I'm gonna paste this in here. So now what will happen is anytime anyone clicks on this link, the link will analyze the device they're using and then send them to a different link appropriately. All right, so we're gonna make sure this worked. We're gonna go back in Instagram here. I'm gonna hit my profile, click on this new link. And bam, there you go. Works like a charm. And that's really all you need to know. So if you found this video helpful, please make sure you give it a like. If you have any questions, head on down to the comment section and let me know. I'll do my best to help out. And I will see you all in the next one later on.